7 years of age, full-time carpenter, have three beautiful daughters, and being incarcerated, it has impacted my family by, just me not being there, the time, the bills, me just being there, for my kids, teaching them, helping them with the homework, helping raise them, and my daughter, sometime, I have to, it just, like, it's kind of hard, because by me being incarcerated, it's taken away from them as it's been me being present, and when you're away, it's like the saying, out of sight, out of mind.
Joining us now is Chris Stewart, attorney for Mr. Brooks's family. Mr. Stewart, what's your reaction to the charges today? Are they appropriate?
Yeah, Anderson, aren't you tired yet of having to fight so hard, march in the streets, fight all of the negative statements and things just to get an arrest in what can easily be viewed factually and legally as an unjustified shooting of an unarmed man running away? Every case is not going to be George Floyd, where we represent his daughter. But that's the world we live in.
How, I'm wondering, I mean, is this kind of what you expected just in terms of charges?
Yes, I mean, like I said, I leave the criminal matters up to the district attorneys in every case, in every city that we have a situation like this, and just hope that they look at all the facts and do their job and come to their conclusion. I mean, we've had situations where we've been heartbroken by the announcement, then we've had some where it's step one towards justice, and you just have to let the criminal justice system play out, and not be angry, not be upset on either side. Just let the system play out how it is, just like in any case of murder.
It certainly seems that the district attorney believes that emotion, anger, perhaps embarrassment that they had a taser taken away from them, whatever, that there was a range of emotions that were leading these officers, or at least this one particular officer, to pull that trigger, even though the man, Mr. Brooks, was known by them to not have a weapon other than the taser that he had taken from them.
Yeah, that was mind-blowing today. His wife actually had to leave the courtroom when we found out that Officer Rolfe kicked him after he was already on the ground dying. To me, as a lawyer, that shows his mental state. It wasn't fear for his life. He was enraged. He was angry from that scuffle, and kicked him, which, you know.
The